Hi, this is Stuart McClure, CEO of Cylance, Inc. And what we're going to talk about today is my favorite topic, Hacking Exposed Live. And the title for this particular session is Next Generation. And really, it's centered and oriented around what we think of today is next generation, sort of the future coming today in terms of how the bad guys are looking at the surface area of attack and how they're exploiting it in real time, and how they will be exploiting it over the coming years and decade. So let's just get right to it. I've got four primary hacks, and as you know from the Hacking Exposed series of presentations, they are all live, and so we typically will do a live demo, but we're going to talk about each and every single one of these attacks in detail and work through every one of them. Now, the first attack is we're calling Captain Unhooking. Now, if you think about the protection technologies out there today, everything from antivirus to EDR, that's Enterprise Detect and Respond, to data loss prevention, to sandboxing or anti-exploitation or whitelisting, blacklisting, any kind of products, any kind of security products really that try to protect or prevent attacks, what happens is they all try to hook the operating system for control of what's going on in the system. And the reason why they do that is so that they can try and interpret what the system is trying to do. Or in the malware case or the advanced persistent threat APT or zero day case, what the program is trying to do, what it's trying to execute, what behavior it's trying to make. And in EDR's case, for example, which is pure visibility, it's trying to just literally see that activity. And the only way that they can actually see the activity is by hooking in the operating system, everything from user land space into kernel space. Well, we've got a way to bypass all of that. And that, even though the technique's been known, no one's ever really shown this before live, and we're going to do that. So, unfortunately, you have to think long and hard about the technologies that you have on the endpoint these days so that you can make sure that you're not vulnerable to this type of attack, but pretty much all vendors are. The second attack that we're going to highlight is what we're calling poison tap, but basically think of it as a poison tap Raspberry Pi that can plug into a USB port on a Windows system that can exploit the system, even on a locked computer, to take full control over the endpoint itself. And once you plug this little Raspberry Pi inside the USB port, it will effectively route all traffic right through the Pi, which will deliver malicious payloads to the user without the user ever knowing it. And being able to take over the system, control it in any way, or put a backdoor in place, spy on it, crypto lock it, wipe it, you name it, can do anything. And we're going to actually use Metasploit to help do that to sort of prove the point around arbitrary code execution from USB port. Third, we're going to get into BIOS hacking, some of my favorite. Well, BIOS tends to be the god position inside of a computer system because it's the first place that code really starts to execute in memory. And BIOS is what handles all the hardware and then, of course, the operating system and all the subsequent componentry of it. So if we could simply send a user a Word document and have that Word document be opened, and that Word document then actually takes over the BIOS, hacks the BIOS, reboots the system, and then forces the user to provide some kind of a Bitcoin or for ransomware, crypto locking, unlocking, or quite simply just wipes the system and bricks it. We're going to show you how to do that quite easily. And then lastly, really, it's been in the news quite a bit. A lot of supposition and speculation around was the U.S. election system breached in some form or fashion last year. And what we're going to show you is how it could have been, not that it was or not that it even probably was, but that it is very possible to have hacked the voting systems out there in the U.S. today. And so we're going to do a little security review of the American voting machines that were used in the election and show you a very simple walk-up hack that can take over the system completely and fabricate whatever results that you want, including putting new candidates in or elevating the number of votes for a particular candidate and fabricating the entire vote count. So with all four of those accounts and hacks, we're going to really show you how easy it is to exploit systems all the way through from operating system all the way down to embedded system and be able to take over devices that you normally never ever thought possible.